I'm going to share with you the most underrated WordPress plugin on the market. Now, this plugin can easily replace 6 to 8 other plugins that you might be using right now. Plus, you can future-proof your website customizations without breaking your website. And if you're like most smart website owners, then you've probably been wishing for this solution a few times during your WordPress journey. Now, I'm talking about the WP Code plugin. WP Code is powerful WordPress code snippet plugin. And that just means that you can turn on or off certain features of WordPress just by adding bits of code. And I know you're probably thinking, okay, that's great, but I don't want to learn code. That's why I use plugins. So how am I supposed to figure out what code to even add? That's the cool part about this plugin. There's a ready-made expert code snippet library that lets you add various popular features. So all of these have been tested, tried and true, and these are the ones that you're usually sent over and shared with many people. And then a lot of times, most of these plugins that you add are really just these bits of code packaged into a whole plugin. And a typical website can use these snippets to reduce at least 6 to 8 other plugins that you might be using right now. And that's just scratching the surface. Let me show you some of the top use cases that this plugin will do or replace. Right from the WP Code dashboard, there is an area called Code Snippets, and this is where you can maintain all of the snippets that you're using. You can also see the status of it. You have it installed, but are you using it? The status over here will show you whether it's enabled or not. And then anytime you want to add a new one, simply come up here, click Add New. You can either create a blank one of one that you already know because maybe you copied from one of our tutorials to share with you, or these are all the snippets that you can choose from. You can click on all snippets and you can see them all. Plus, as you're scrolling through, you can see which ones are already being used. Some of my favorite ones for this is you can do things like add an updated date on your post and you can choose where to put that. If you want to put it before the content or after the content, this is really helpful in keeping everything fresh. You can show them when the last time that has been updated. You can also do things like disable attachment pages. So pages on your front end from all visitors, they can't go to those attachment pages. If you don't like Gutenberg block editor, you can disable that right here and start using the classic editor as well. If you don't like having the WP admin bar when people log in, you can disable that from here. You can also disable things like the XML RPC. You can disable comments. That's one of our biggest tutorials on how do I disable comments. I don't want any comments whatsoever. You can do that here. You can scroll through and just see how many snippets of code that you can use right now to really improve the performance of your website and reduce the number of plugins that you have. And then because it is from insert headers and footers, they still have the insert header and footer area where you insert your script. Many third-party applications usually ask you to do this to either verify your website with them. You can do Google Analytics with here as well. If you need to verify like with Pinterest, or if you do any kind of pixel coding, you can insert the script from pixel code. If you use Amazon Associates and you need to add the script in order to add the affiliate links on your site, then you can do that as well here. That is still very much a part of this here. And then under library, it's still showing all of these snippets that you can choose from. And now let's look at the generator. So the generator, this is where you can quickly get ready to use custom code using the latest WordPress standards and APIs. So if you need to do things like use this to generate custom post status for your posts, you can also use the post type to generate a custom post type for your website. So many things that you can use on here to really increase what your site can do. A couple of other examples is you can also use the custom taxonomy generator. That means that you can get it custom code snippet for taxonomies. You can also use the custom code snippet for the WP query to load posts on your site. If you're doing a custom widget, you can do the custom widget generator to allow you to register custom widgets for your site, as well as a menu generator. So a navigation menu, you can do custom code snippet to register new navigation menus for your theme. Aside from all of that, there are plenty of scheduling cron jobs, registering scripts, style sheets, and adding custom post status and more. Under tools, if you already use a snippet generator, then you can use this area to import those areas. You could also do this to export. So if you have everything set up how you want, you can export that. And then here you can also get the system info. This is always helpful if you're having support with your website. They usually ask you some system information and you can share that information with them. And then under settings, if you just want to maintain and keep insert headers and footers mode, you don't need the snippets, then they make it super easy to simply enable this. Once you save changes, then it goes back to a simple insert headers and footers section where you're just adding the bits of script for your website. Then whenever you're ready to take it to the next level, we can disable the simple mode, and now you have your snippets again. When you choose the snippet, you see the code preview right from here. And then here's some very powerful features of this. From here, you can choose how to insert it. Most people, you're going to want to auto insert. That means it's automatically going to insert this, and they have a location dropdown where you can choose where to put this, whether you want to for PHP snippets only, whether you want to run it everywhere, the front end only or the admin only. So this makes it super simple to have conditional smart logic. So you're only running it for certain people who are either logged in or just admins only, or you can run everywhere. Same thing with site-wide and page-by-page. So the page-by-page, this is super helpful if you're wanting to add, maybe add revenue on your site, maybe you want to add affiliate links on your site. You can do this right here where it's automatically adding that bit of code for your site. It's one of the things that I use. I'll do my affiliate, Amazon affiliate information. I'll get the code from them, and then I can add that snippet up at the top and choose where to put it. I'll typically put it in a couple of places, maybe after four or five paragraphs, and then maybe another one towards the bottom. So that's super helpful. Or you can also do it manually. So you can choose to do short code and you can do it manually, but the auto insert is very powerful. Some other information down here is you have priority. So you can tag things up so that you can work, say you're working a lot of admin related stuff, you can tag things as admin, or in this particular case, if we scroll up, we're displaying the last updated date. So we have a tag of date because I'm dealing with dates. So we could tag all of these with dates, and then if we wanted to, we could sort or group them as well. Plus they have a priority level. So if I have a lot of snippets running, then I can give one a higher priority over others so there's no conflict. And then you always want to keep notes just so that you know what's going on. And then down here is the smart conditional logic. If you hover over here, it just limits when and how the snippets are going to be run. If you enable that, then you can choose exactly how to run this, whether it's logged in user, different user role, different page URL or referrer, post type, and more. And then you can see what they are here. And then you can stack them to show based on multiple areas. For instance, this will be any kind of single post or page, and any kind of only just a post. So take a little bit of time and go through this plugin. You'll start to see the power that this has for your website. And again, let us know in the comments below of any suggestions or what you think about the plugin. And thanks for watching.